we're here in the ICU today to do a TEE on a COVID positive or COVID suspected patient. We have assembled all of our equipment to do the TEE in one place, including the portable machine, the probe, all the medications as ordered by the doctor, drawn up and labeled for individual use, and as well as a surgical mask for the patient to be worn to prevent airborne transmission or droplets while removing the probe. We've got the cardiologist and the sonographer here to do the procedure. Normally we would minimize the number of people in the room to only those who absolutely have to be present. Today I'm here to guide donning and doffing PPE. If I'm not here, the cardiologist and the sonographer can be each other's spotters and guide each other through the process, but we'll do it together. Procedure. So prior to donning the PPE, they'll remove all of their personal items, whether it's a stethoscope, ID badge, pager, and make sure that hair is tied up and hands are free of any sort of jewelry, dress, watches, rings, anything that's on the hands or the wrists. And we then perform hand hygiene with alcohol-based hand rub, rubbing the gel over all surfaces of the hands for at least 15 seconds or until the gel is well dried. When the gel's dried, we don a long-sleeve fluid-resistant isolation gown. Donning the gown, we tie both the tie at the neck and the one at the waist. Because TEE is a potentially aerosolizing procedure, we're going to be wearing an N95 mask for the procedure as fit tested. We begin by pulling the top strap of the mask over the top of the head to go over the ears and behind the head. Okay. And we next pull the bottom strap over the head as before, only to be lined under the ears at the nape of the neck. Alright. The middle nose piece is then molded using two hands to the bridge of the nose to ensure it's a secured seal. And both hands are cupped around the mask while exhaling forcefully to feel for any air escaping to do a seal check. If any air escaping is felt, adjustments are made as necessary to ensure a tight fit, and then the visor is donned. The visor is worn with the strap behind the head at the crown to ensure that it's seating securely and comfortably covering the wearer's entire face. And when that's done, a head cover is worn to cover all of the wearer's hair, the earlobes, as well as the top edges of the mask. Making sure that the sleeves of the gown are down around the hands, covering the wrists nicely. What's up? Two pairs of gloves are worn. Starting with the first pair, ideally we use long cut nitrile gloves to make sure there's a good coverage at the wrist and none of the wearer's skin can be seen. The wearers then make any final adjustments to make sure that they have full range of motion and that their equipment is comfortable and secure, because once you go in the room, it's important not to touch your PPE. It's now time to begin the procedure.
Hi, Mr. Smith. I'm Dr. Law. I'm here to do your transesophageal echocardiogram. I will explain the procedure, and then if you agree, I will ask you to sign the consent form.
Okay.
Wherever possible, the patient should provide signed consent, which is done on paper after cleaning the overbed table with disinfectant wipes. Providing a pen with a smooth barrel and non-retractable tip.
If you agree, just sign here. Thank you. The tube is coming out. All right, you might cough quite a bit after we take it out, so I'm just going to put a mask on you. There we go, we're going to have to wipe everything down before we wipe down all the equipment once inside the room. And now,
prolonged procedure by the door of the room to minimize contact with any potential particles in the air. The cardiologist and the sonographer will then doff their PPE. Beginning with the outer pair of gloves, if not already removed, these will be removed and thrown into the garbage bin. Next, the inner pair of gloves will be removed. Using the wearer's dominant hand, the gloves will be pinched at the wrist of the non-dominant hand and brought out and down towards the fingers to turn the glove inside out. Using the non-dominant hand and touching only the clean inside surfaces of the removed glove, the dominant hand glove will likewise be removed, pulling it out from the wrist, down and over the fingers, turning inside out as you go. After discarding the gloves, hand hygiene is repeated with alcohol-based hand rub, using the same principles as when donning the grip, rubbing all surfaces of the hands for at least 15 seconds or until the gel is dry. After this, the gowns will be removed, first untying the waist tie when the hands are dry. Next, the tie from around the neck is unfastened, and the ends of the tie are used to bring the gown up and forward away from the wearer as it is turned inside out and rolled inwards on itself to contain the soiled surfaces on the inside and the clean surfaces on the outside. Hand hygiene is repeated. The head cover will be removed. The wearer begins by leaning slightly forward and pointing the chin outward. Reaching behind the head with both hands, the head cover is lifted away from the back of the head, up and over the head, in front of the wearer, and discarded. Hand hygiene is repeated. Using both hands, the wearer then releases the visor by reaching behind the head to move the strap up and over while leaning slightly forward as before with the chin pointed out. Hand hygiene is repeated and all respiratory protection needs to remain as is while in the patient room. After completing hand hygiene, the equipment is brought through the door to the anteroom, if available, outside of the patient's room. The cardiologist and the sonographer exit the room and close the door behind them. after exiting the procedure room and making sure the door behind them is closed, the consent sheet is placed face down on the counter in the ante room so as to protect patient person or privacy. And all surfaces of the equipment that have been touched after opening the door of the room are then wiped with disinfectant.
I have to bring everything back downstairs to send everything off to Deacon Town to get cleaned.
We wiped every part of the box, including the bottom.
Yes.
Good. Okay. This machine is clean too.
Okay. Even the outside of the wipes.
Yes.
And the lidocaine canister. Once more, performing hand hygiene. Staff prepares to remove the N95 respirator. Leaning slightly forward with the chin out, the wearer reaches behind their head with both hands to locate the bottom strap of the N95 respirator and brings it carefully over their head to their front, taking care not to touch their mask or face and avoiding contact with the strap. The step is repeated for the top strap. Reaching behind the head with both hands, the strap is brought over the head, and the mask is lifted up and away from the wearer and discarded. Hand hygiene is repeated a final time.